Hey guys, welcome back to the channel with more of The Witcher. This is Season 1, Episode 6. And yeah, last time we saw Yennefer and Geralt finally meet, and that was really fascinating to see the djinn and her trying to take control of it and be the vessel. Meanwhile, Geralt was able to save her with this wish that the show didn't fully say out loud. Yaskier was so happy when he found out that they were still alive, or he was still alive, Geralt. And Ciri has been taken by the Doppler, who is now impersonating Mousak, which is just, that's so bad. But I'm curious to see how this all continues, how Yennefer, if Yennefer and Geralt will stick together for a bit. They're very into each other, so yeah, and curious if Mousak, the Doppler, will reveal himself at some point to Ciri by accident or otherwise. Maybe she has a bit of silver on her, or we'll find some and he'll react in a certain way. But yeah, she's also traveling with Dara. He feels like he's gonna be collateral damage at some point, but we'll see. Anyway, guys, if you want to watch the full reaction or you want to see episodes a week early, you can check out Patreon in the link in the description below. Otherwise, let's get started.
I see no steel here.
Oh!
Steel won't be necessary.
This woman just killed a man with her bare hands for trying to steal your horse.
Maybe she'll make a better travel companion then.
Ouch!
What? Your adventures are legend.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
I suppose you want me to.
You have the most incredible neck. It's like a sexy goose. Guzzling.
Now the king is in a bind. He's set to marry the princess of his rival kingdom.
You'd think he'd be smoother. Ooh.
Come with me. I'll show you what you're missing.
What am I missing?
Oh, look at that.
I'm in.
How is it that I've walked this earth for decades without coming across a Witcher? And then the first one I meet, I can't get rid of.
Witchers are bound to bump into monsters eventually.
Ooh.
Yes, Gio.
You wander aimlessly into this thicket and retrieve for you a tasty afternoon treat.
Why are you weird?
Cutest, most terrifying thing I've ever seen in my entire life. Run away, Geralt!
Oh my god.
He's probably starving.
Oh jeez. What the heck, man?
For kingdom and glory!
Spike.
So the Witcher wants to play knight too, huh?
No. She's plenty able of murdering you herself.
What sort?
Will you be joining me?
Never degrade your honor. That ship has sailed, wrecked, and sunk to the bottom of the ocean. Ow.
Ow.
Queen Calanthe would die before letting them take what's hers.
And she died.
Perhaps if Nilfgaard's religious zeal had been tempered earlier by a stronger hand.
What does he know about that? I would assume only the mages knew about Yennefer being originally for Nilfgaard.
Black dragons are the rarest.
Gold dragons are rarest.
Gold.
Gold dragons are a myth.
I was pulled through a portal by Nilfgaard.
We.
Kidnapped and held prisoner for days.
Something's off about this, Ciri. Do you know what happens to people who escape a siege? They get captured and they get turned. Remember what the Dry Queen said?
He's able to hear all this, damn it.
Princess! I forgot. I brought this for you.
Stop! Stop! Creep! Mother. Dara knows. Dara knows.
Who slits a man's throat while he's relieving his bowels? Nothing's sacred anymore.
What are you really doing here?
I'm here for the dragon. There are certain healing properties it's rumored to possess.
Oh.
You? My mother?
Do you think I'd make a bad one?
Dude. Don't laugh it off.
Definitely.
Probably, but don't.
Bien.
Rather use my child's surprise as Brooks a bait than subject it to this life.
What did you just say?
Oh, fuck. Every time I'm near you, I say more in 5 minutes than I've said in weeks.
You have arthritis. You hate the cold. And you always said Skellig was where you came from, but Sintra was your home with us.
Ah, damn it. It had to be a surprise attack. There's no... Silver! Oh, are we seeing a true form here? Oh!
Kill him!
What? Wait, no!
Oh, shoot. Hopefully he doesn't kill Dara.
Yeah, you're right, this is a shortcut. To death. He does
reavers or no?
Ladies first.
She pushed him.
He will save us yet. But first, you must let go.
No.
What? What the heck? What was with all the fog then?
Huh. Every time you leave.
You left fast. I woke up in the destroyed house and you were gone.
Forgive me.
That was really tender.
Did you always want to become a mother?
I dreamed of becoming important to someone.
That's why she wants to have a child?
Do I bore you?
Not at all.
He was just...
You're important to me.
After he met her, he could finally sleep. Boy, you better not have left. There's the little smile. You don't know where the Nilfgaardians are? Should have just taken, try to take out the Doppler. God dang it.
You are the key to everything, Cirilla.
Are you that dense? You think she'd accept?
You must be starving.
A drink from you or food? What? What? Oh, the cup was silver. Damn.
You fucking fool.
Oh boy. I lost track of who's who already. Oh. Possibly, but I think he got out.
Be quiet.
Oh. It looks like it's dying.
No closer.
Ooh. That's what that meant.
Oh.
What? The golden dragon. Damn. And he was saying, Geralt was saying, just this episode, that they were a myth.
She was protecting her baby.
White-haired Witcher. The knight who was taught to save dragons instead of kill them.
Ooh. And now it's time to help.
Fart! Now!
He took the time to kiss during the middle of a battle. She's a lot better with weaponry than I thought. What's the gold dragon doing? Oh, Oh. Oh, no. They work well together. He's still sleeping here. He missed everything.
Oh, God. Oh, bloody hell. What the fuck are you doing here?
And his clothing is reminiscent of the Golden Scales.
Ask no questions, and in return, I offer you these to take to the king.
Oh. Oh, it could still be the Doppler.
And you're just like Kalanthe. You bring terror, and you bring death wherever you are!
Doing the best that I can.
Find a new family. Because I can't be that for you anymore.
This is my final first. Child.
Oh.
I can see why Geralt didn't want to lose you.
That glare. Oh, damn.
The djinn.
That's why we can't escape each other.
What? No, what?
Not because of anything real.
A child is no way to boost your fragile ego, Yen.
I'll take advice from you about children as soon as you take responsibility for the one you bound to you and then abandoned!
God damn it.
Though you didn't want to lose her, Geralt, you will.
He already has.
If that's what the wish was, then she wouldn't be able to do that, right? I don't even know.
You wanted to show me what I was missing. There she goes.
What you're missing is still out there. Your leg.
Ciri.
Ooh, what a day.
Yaskir, not now.
Imagine you'll probably.
Damn it, Yaskir! Why is it whenever I find myself in a pile of shit these days, it's you shoveling it?
That's not fair.
The child surprise! The djinn! All of it! If life could give me one blessing, it would be to take you off my hands.
See you around, girl.
Oh, he just went ahead and slaughtered everybody, okay.
They're combing the area. They haven't found him. We will find her. And we will spread his supremacy all through the kingdoms, whether they deserve it or not.
Deserve.
Gather the men.
As if this is like a noble thing they're doing.
The time of the sword and the axe is nigh.
That was really sad. Poor Yennefer. Geralt. No happy ending. Though I guess I doubt this is the ending. More Yaskir songs. So this wound up being just a all-around really sad episode. Like, it seemed like everything was going to be mostly fine until the golden dragon had to blow up Geralt's spot. But, yeah, at the beginning we have the dwarves, reavers, and the overeager knight with Yennefer. And Yennefer's just using him to get to the dragon, I suppose. And there are some clues that the man is in fact a dragon. Like, you can tell something is up. Like, first his guardian saying that they guard him because he is the most beautiful. That is... it's weird. I mean, it's not to judge their, like, aesthetic sensibilities, but I'm just like, why is that a reason to guard anybody for that reason, or fight with them for that reason? Yaskir was just like, what? Like, And it's actually very cool that his outermost layer of clothing actually has the look of, like, dragon scales. Plus, he tells the stupid knight not to eat the food, and he's like, it can't be good for you. And when he and his guardians let go at the cliff, when, like, Geralt was holding onto them with a chain, he said that Geralt would save them later, and I was like, okay, they're not gonna die, but I don't know what that means, how would they survive? It turns out he fell first into the fog so that he could become the dragon, and the guardians just rode on his back, probably, right? And I'm curious, like, did the boards give out because, like, does he have, like, conservation of mass here? Was he as heavy as dragon, and that's why the boards broke? But either way, I guess Geralt holding him by the chain would have tipped him off if he was if he did have the mass of a dragon. But yeah, Jaskier continues to be a joy to watch. I don't know if he's my favorite character on the entire show, but it's just, he's super, super entertaining. But he's, like, really awkward when it comes to women, though. Like, it certainly seemed like he was a playboy back in earlier episodes with how, like, going into court, he was just like, everybody's really mad at me for, like, sleeping with their wives or whatever. But then he's just like, he was so awkward last episode with Yennefer. I guess he was scared, but he was just like, I left my cat on the stove. And then the way he is with these two black women, like, you guys have beautiful necks, like sexy goose, like guzzling. I'm like, what? That night, though, Geralt says that the thing that they were, that came out to them that was starving was an Erica. I don't know what that, how do you pronounce that, but he says it was just starving, and the knight just slashes it to pieces. Just, no, I don't know, there's something wrong with him, but he chooses to eat it as well, against the recommendation of the Golden Dragon. And I thought he just, like, shit himself to death, but it turns out he was, like, murdered by a reaver while he was emptying his bowels. I think it would be funnier if he had shit himself to death. But there's this wonderfully romantic moment with Yennefer and Geralt. We find out that they've spent so much time together over however many months or weeks that have gone by. But she always leaves because he left that first time. And they actually are very vulnerable with each other in these few moments. Geralt says that after meeting her, his insomnia was cured. He asks why, if she always wanted a baby, and she says that she just really wanted to be important to someone. And he tells her she's important to him. My heart. I mean, I was just, last episode, I was talking about how Yennefer's kind of a monster, but I don't know. It's, I mean, Jaskier even makes fun of her for being a monster this episode. She was saying how she can't seem to get rid of this Witcher, and Jaskier was saying how Witchers often run into monsters, so it's, that's the reason why they keep bumping into each other. But yeah, like, I actually, despite thinking of her as kind of a monster, it is an interesting romance to watch, and I'm actually rooting for them. But then it comes out that this wish was, like, something that drew Geralt and her together, which can't be right, right? It just seems like, because if the wish was actually that they are, like, together forever, then, or, like, if they're, like, brought together, then she wouldn't have been able to find out, she wouldn't have been able to leave, and what the dragon said couldn't be true, which is that he'll lose her, and also it wouldn't explain why the djinn left her alive. I have no idea. But then, like, I didn't expect the Doppler in Ciri's story to cave so soon. Like, he was annoyed at Ciri's questions so much that Dara, like, caught on that it wasn't him. And then Ciri poked around a little, and I thought he has the memories and knowledge of Mousesack, but the personality doesn't stick around. Like, he just completely, like, caved way too easily. He just, like, admitted who he was. And then we have that fight scene with Ciri, Dara, and this Doppler, and they happen to have a piece of silver dagger. Unfortunately, Dara couldn't bring himself to kill the Doppler, which, I mean, there was no other choice in that moment. Ciri was just like, you have to slay him now, and he was just shocked, because, I mean, I guess coming from her, the granddaughter of Calanthe, who committed genocide against his race, it wasn't something that it gave him pause, and yeah, it wound up kind of screwing them over. But yeah, she gets captured, he was left unconscious, but Dara comes back and frees Ciri, but then leaves her all on her own. Like, he sees too much death and terror and destruction following her, and he sees too much of Calanthe in her, And now that Ciri is on her own again and in serious danger, it's time for Geralt to find her, right? Hopefully. Like, we only have 2 episodes left. Like, this destiny must happen this season at some point. And then with Ciri, or the Doppler posing as Ciri, ran and got caught by Cahir, I thought for sure that Ciri was just, like, running off, and I was like, this is not the best idea, because you don't know who's out there. You know that Mousesack, or you know that the Doppler posing as Mousesack is bringing you, I don't know if to Nilfgaardians or just to some of her enemies. So I was just like, running around might not be the best idea, but yeah, she wound up getting caught by the Doppler, and the Doppler wound up getting caught on purpose by the Nilfgaardians, Cahir specifically. And that fight was really, really interesting, because I just couldn't tell who was who at first, and like, one of them got stabbed, and I'm like, who got stabbed? I'm not sure, but yeah, the Doppler also has like knowledge of Cahir's fighting style as well, and the last thing we saw was that the Doppler got their face slashed, so I don't know what that means going forward. I don't think any bodily injuries are lasting for Dopplers, I'm guessing, but it's interesting that we saw him get his face slashed, and then, yeah, I don't know what that means. Cahir wound up slaughtering everybody because he thought, like, oh, possibly, like, they changed, the Doppler changed, and took someone's place, like, took a random person's place in the bar. Though I feel like he could have just asked everybody what happened, because they would very obviously see somebody, like, shifting in the middle of a... He got away, though. Don't know what their role... I mean, yeah, don't know what their role is going to be going forward. The last scene is Cahir talking to Fringilla, and she's talking him up and saying how the White Flame chose him for this. And Fringilla's choice of words, we will spread this his supremacy all through the kingdoms, whether they deserve it or not. I feel like deserve is such a deliberate word, because deserving means, like, they think that they're spreading good across all the kingdoms, right? They really think what they're doing is right. And they think what they're doing is beneficial to the people they conquer and roll over, which just, ugh. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. If you want to see the next episode a week early, or if you want to see full reactions, you can check out Patreon in the link in the description below. And thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time.